सुईद
सर।
यस टेल मी
Sir, I do not know if it is correct or not.
Okay, so tell me, what is the limiting reagent first in this question? Please write in chat. I cannot hear you. Your voice is lagging. Is my voice audible? Is my voice clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Abdul Wahid, it seems that you did not write the question. Yes.
Right. What's the question? But I didn't solve it.
Okay. So did you do the steps, Shoaib? Did you do it in steps? And what about Mehreen? Yes, Mehreen, can you please unmute yourself? Please write in chat. Did you try this question or not? Yes, Mehreen, I cannot see anything in the chat also. Can you please speak at least? Yeah, I understand that you can have network issue, that you cannot unmute, but tell me, did you do this question or not? What is the limiting reagent then? Is the limiting reagent, Mehreen? Please write "I don't know" or something at least. Okay, Abdul Wahid, it seems yeah that you can speak. Yes, Abdul Wahid.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, fine. So let us try this question. Okay, let us try this question. We have been already given the moles. 2 moles of H2 and 4 moles of fluorine. So what is the first step, Abdul Wahid? What is the first step?
I'm not sure.
Okay, I cannot hear it.
I'm not sure.
The first. No, I could not. Okay, no. Something. I cannot hear your voice.
Sir, I'm not sure.
You're not sure? You haven't seen the previous questions or what? I mean, can you? We have already always did need statement, one question. Need statements, 2 questions. Need statements, 3 questions. Third question, okay? From past 3 questions, we have been doing the first step is need statement if you have already found the number of moles. First of all, what we do? We find the number of moles. We found the number of most, and the next part was need statements, and after that was form statement. So here also we have already got the number of most, so we'll directly write need statements. Okay, need statements. Now in this need statement, what we will write here, the first thing, according to stoichiometry, 1 mole of H2 needs 1 mole of F2. How many moles of H2 do we have? 2 moles. 2 moles of H2 needs dash mole of F2. I need the answers in chat. One mole of H2 needs one mole of F2. So 2 moles of H2 will need how many moles of F2? Yes, correct. Yes, correct. We need 4 moles. Okay. So it's very problematic, na? If you don't understand the basic concept. Maybe you guys are not present. You guys don't answer anything. You guys don't even write in chat. You don't even read the notes, I guess. That is why you don't know what is the first step. What is happening here? Tell me. Marine, can you tell me? What will be the answer here? 2 moles of H2 needs how many moles of F2 according to this chemical equation? Yes, very good, Marine. 2 moles. And Shreyab, if you have some doubt, please figure it out, okay? So you have some very conceptual doubt here. Because if I am saying one person needs 1 kg of sweets, then obviously 2 person will need 2 kg of sweets. I don't know how did you get that 4. Please figure this out. And the first thing that you should do is to figure out how to fix your mic. So 2 moles of H2 needs 2 moles of F2. Now, how many moles of F2 is there? We have 4 moles of F2. Now tell me, we have more than needed or less than needed? The need is of 2 moles. We have 4 moles. So tell me in chat, we have more than needed or less than needed? Yes, Mehreen, correct. More than needed. So tell me, some of the F2 will be unreacted or all F2 will react? Some of F2 will be unreacted. Right now, if something is more than needed, that means the other thing will be completely consumed, and hence H2 will be completely consumed. We are doing the same steps for the fourth time now. Okay, doing the same steps for the fourth time. H2 will be completely consumed. Now tell me, what is the limiting reagent? Is it H2 or F2? Which will be the limiting reagent, F2 or H2? If you don't know, read the definition of limiting reagent and then answer. Yes, Shreyab, correct. What about Abdul Wahid? Yes, Abdul Wahid. No, I could not hear it. So please use chat, whatever you are saying. Mehreen, which will be the limiting reagent? Limiting reagent is? H2 or F2? Please read the definition of limiting reagent and after that answer, Mehreen. Yes, Mehreen, correct. Limiting reagent is H2. Now, once we have identified the limiting reagent, what is the next thing that we do? We write the form statements. In form statements, according to the equation, we will start with H2, okay? According to the equation, 1 mole of H2 gives 2 moles of HF. 1 mole of H2 gives 2 mole of HF. That is why, how many moles do we have? 2 mole of H2 gives how many moles of HF? Please write in chat, how many moles of HF? I received 2 chats. Yes, Mehreen, correct. Abdul Wahid, correct. What about Shoaib? How many moles of HF? Shoaib, please read this statement. Please read statement. 1 mole gives 2 moles. So 2 moles will also be giving 2 moles. Answer me this. What is the difference? What is the difference between this question and this question? Shreya, tell me the difference between that question and this question. No? What is the difference? Is there any difference? Yes or no? Okay, now whenever you are in confusion, maybe these moles, these terms, moles and H2 and HF, these may be intimidating you. So what you have to do, whenever you are in confusion that you don't know, then you will translate to this type of question and then answer it. Okay, this is unitary method. It has been taught to you in 6th standard, 7th standard. It is easy, I understand that. But many students, it's not only you, Shoaib, many students face this difficulty in which they cannot do unitary method when they come to 11th standard. Now, what is the way? Whenever you have confusion for these type of statements, in your mind, imagine some situation like this. Translate these, the same questions to some other question, and then you can get the answer, okay? So we will get 4 moles of HF. That's it. So please copy this. Let me know if I have to scroll up or down. And Mary, what happened? Why is your internet weak today? Usually it is fine. Okay, Marion. Let me know if I have to scroll down or scroll up, okay? Yes, are you guys done? Okay. You have also written the okay. Abdul Wahid is done. Waiting for Shoaib now. Everyone is done. So you guys are completely done, right? I can move on. Yes or no? Okay. Please revise, guys. Okay. If you don't study, then you won't get anything. Everything will be vaporing out from the brain. Okay. Let me wait a second. So for previous days, let me go to today's date. Yeah. Write a new question here. Calculate the amount of CO2. Calculate the amount of CO2 formed by. Combustion of 8 gram of CH4. Now, in this question, first of all, we will write the chemical reaction. So, whenever combustion is taking place, combustion means it is reaction with oxygen. Whenever there is combustion, that means it is reaction with O2. Okay, it is the reaction with O2. So, you have CH4 plus O2. When they will react, carbon, when it reacts with oxygen, it will form CO2. Hydrogen, when it reacts with oxygen, it will give you H2O. So we have here 4 hydrogens. So I will write 2 here. That means it is 4 hydrogen now. We have 2 oxygen here. We have 4 oxygens here. So I will write 2 oxygens, 2 O2 molecules. Now it is completely balanced. Now, in this reaction, we have been given only you have to find the amount of CO2 formed by the combustion of 8 gram of CH4. So out of these two reactants, we have been given just the number of the mass of CH4. So we'll calculate the number of moles of CH4. It will be equal to given mass by molar mass. So the given mass of CH4 is 8 grams. Molar mass is 12 plus 4, 12 for carbon, 4 for hydrogen grams per mole. This will give you 8 by 16 grams. Grams will cancel out each other. You will get 8 by 16 moles. That is 1 by 2 mole. Now, in limiting reagent, I have written a second point. We have written a second point in which we said limiting reagent is only determined when the amount of two or more reactants is given. Please check it and tell me if yes or no. Limiting reagent is determined only when, only if amount of two or more reactant is given. Please look in your notes and tell me, is this statement present in your notes or not, with a yes or no? In the heading where we did limiting reagent, please look. Yes, Mehreen can see that statement. What about others? Shoaib, Abdul Wahid. What about Shoaib, Abdul Wahid? You cannot see this statement. And the next question is, should we determine the limiting reagent in this question? Yes or no, Mehreen? Should we determine the limiting reagent in this question? Yes or no? I think we have to determine the limiting reagent, Mehreen. I am saying limiting reagent is determined only if the amount of two or more reactant is given. We have been given the amount of only one reactant. Then why do we need to calculate the limiting reagent? Okay, guys, what happened? I hope you are seeing things, listening to things. Still, you are answering just the opposite. It is written in the slide that the limiting reagent is only determined if the amount of two or more reactant is given. In the question, we have been given the reactant, the amount of reactant of for only one reactant. Then obviously we don't need to calculate, we don't need to determine the limiting reagent. Yes or no, Mehreen? You guys are just writing yes, sir. I don't know whether anything is going in your head or not. Now, if this is the case, then I will be just keep on solving the questions and you will be just copying the things. You will not understand anything. The only thing why small batches are taken in this institute is that we can interact with you guys. Now, neither you guys reply actively in the chat, and most of the times you say that your internet is weak. So what will happen, even though this is for some personal interaction we have, but small batches, still you will be facing the same problems which you are facing in large questions. Why? Because you are not interacting. So if you want to make use of that, then please start answering at least yes, sir, no, sir questions. And most of the questions that I ask, they are already present in the screen. They are already present in the notes. I don't ask you to keep your notes closed and then answer me. Most of the time I say that, please see your notes and then answer. Now, even then, if you are not willing to participate, if you are not willing to interact, then this chemistry class will be very tough, because most of the things that I explain is just by asking questions. Okay. Now, limiting reagent is determined only if the amount of two or more reactant is given. We have here only the amount of CH4, so we don't need to determine the limiting reagent. And if we don't need to determine the limiting reagent, we also don't need to write the need statement. So directly we will write the form statements. Now, in form statements, what do we have? In form statements, first of all, we write with the equation. What is the equation? CH4. So here we have CH4, the amount of CH4 only. So we'll start with CH4, one mole of CH4 gives. How many moles of CO2? One mole of CO2. How many moles of CH4 do we have? Half moles. Half mole of CH4 will give half mole of CO2. Now we have got half mole of CO2. Now we will determine the mass of half mole of CO2 is equal to number of moles into molar mass of CO2. Number of moles is 1/2. The molar mass of CO2 is 44. We write it in grams and units also. So it'll be half mole into 44 grams per mole. This mole and mole will cancel each other and we will get 22 grams, just that's it. Moles and moles have been cancelled out. Please write this. Raise your hand if you're done. Just waiting for Shoaib now. You write another question. Okay, there is a reaction given, CaCO3 reacts with 2HCl. To give calcium chloride plus H2O plus CO2. Let us see if this is balanced or not. There are two hydrogens here, two chlorines here, one carbon here. There's one calcium here, there's one calcium here. Let us check the oxygen now. There are three oxygens here. There are one oxygen and three oxygens here, okay? This is the reaction. According to above reaction, what mass of CaCO3 is required to completely react with of 0.75 molar HCl. Now this question will seem something different from the other question, but the things are the same. The first step is to calculate the number of moles. Now, if you are asked about the reactant, then we will use the need statement. And the last one is form statement. If we have been asked to calculate the amount of product, okay? So obviously number of moles we have to do. Now they are asking what mass of CaCO3 is required. So they are asking what mass of CaCO3 is required. That means they are asking about the reactant. So we'll need the need statement. For form statement, they are not asking about the product. So we will not write the form statement. So number of moles and then need statement. So number of moles of what? So firstly, we will see what is the information given. We have been given 25 ml of HCl for one of the reactant. We have not been given mass, we have not been given the number of molecules, we have not been given the volume. We have been given the volume of a particular concentration of HCl. So from there also we can calculate the number of moles. How? We have been given this is the molarity. So we know that molarity, capital M, molarity is equal to number of moles divided by the volume of solution in liters. Number of moles is number of moles divided by volume of solution in liters. And that is why number of moles will be equal to the molarity into the volume of solution in liters. What is the molarity given here? It is 0.75. Okay, this will be moles liter inverse into what is the volume given? It is 25 ml. So 25, if I divide this by 1000, this will become liters. Now liters and liter inverse will cancel out each other and you will get 0.75 into 25 whole divided by 1000 mole. Now please calculate this. Tell me what is the answer. What is the number of moles here? Give the answer in chat. Yes, Abdul Wahid, correct. The number of moles is equal to 0.01875 moles. Now we have got the moles. Now what do we need? We just need to write the need statement according to the chemical reactions. According to the chemical reaction. So need statement. According to chemical reaction, chemical equation or chemical reaction. According to chemical equation, that means we don't need to, okay, for the first statement, in need statement, for the first statement, we don't need to worry about how many moles do we have. We have to just look at the chemical equation. In that, we see that if we have 2 moles of HCl, we require 1 mole of CaCO3. If we have 2 moles of HCl, we require 1 mole of CaCO3. So if you will write 2 mole of HCl. Requires 1 mole of CaCO3. Now tell me 1 mole of HCl. Requires dash mole of CaCO3. One mole of HCl requires dash mole of CaCO3. Guys, fast. Yes, Maureen, correct. 2 moles required 1 mole, then 1 mole will require 1 by 2 moles of CaCO3. This one, we're talking about this or these statements. This need statements, it is not required to write. Obviously, it is not required to write. If you are writing directly like this, that is fine. But whenever I write need statement, I write them because you need to have some clarity, na? Some strategy. So first of all, you calculate the number of moles. Then you write the need statements, right? So just to have that strategy, the way how to do questions, that is why I always write the need statement. That you are in control of the flow. So 1 mole of HCl requires 1/2 mole of CaCO3. How many moles? Now, these two statements does not have to do anything with your the number of moles that you have. The next statement is to do something by number of moles. How many number of moles do you have? So you have 0.01875 mole of HCl needs 0.01875 into 1/2 mole of CaCO3. Okay. So what will be this one? You will get a 75 half will be 325, I guess. 375 and 18 half is 9, so it will be 0.009375 mole of CaCO3. Please let me know now if this is right or not. What is the half of 0.01875? It should be 0.009375. Mass of CaCO3 needed? 0.009375 is equal to number of moles into the molar mass of CaCO3. Number of moles is equal to 0.009375. The molar mass of CaCO3 is, we have already calculated once in this same type of reaction, it is 100 grams per mole. This will be in mole, this will be grams per mole. This mole and mole inverse, mole and mole will cancel out each other, and you will get 0.9375 grams as the answer. Yes. So please let me know if you are done raising the hand. Write a new topic, empirical formula and molecular formula. Now these empirical formula and molecular formula, like the statements, the formula which gives the simplest whole number ratio, the formula which gives the simplest whole number ratio various elements present in a molecule called as empirical formula is known as, it's called as empirical formula. Another statement is for molecular formula, the formula which gives the exact number of different elements present in a molecule, it's called as molecular formula. Okay. So empirical formula and molecular formula. What is empirical formula? In empirical formula, you will have the simplest whole number ratio. Okay. It would be the simplest whole number ratio. In molecular formula, it will give you the exact number of elements that is present in a molecule. So stop, please stop writing and see this example. For example, you have a molecule whose name is hydrogen peroxide. The formula for hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. So this H2O2 is the molecular formula. Okay, it is the molecular formula. The empirical formula will be what? The empirical formula will be, if we simplify this ratio, the ratio is 2:2, right? The ratio is 2:2. So if we simplify it, it will be HO. So this HO is what? Empirical formula. Did you guys get it? The difference between molecular formula and empirical formula. In molecular formula, you will get the exact number of elements that are present in a molecule. In empirical formula, you just have to take the simplest whole number ratio of that. For example, in H2O2, the molecular formula is there are two hydrogens and the two oxygens. The structure is something like this. Okay, H2O2 is something like this. So in this one molecule, we have, this is one molecule. We have two hydrogens and two oxygens. So that is the molecular formula. But in empirical formula, you just simplify it. The ratio is 2:2. So for each, for two hydrogens, we need two oxygens. That is the formula. So you just have to simplify it 1:1. For each hydrogen, you require one oxygen. Okay. So this is the empirical formula. That is the molecular formula. The next term that is important are the molecular mass, the molecular formula mass, and empirical formula mass. So what is a molecular formula mass for? If I say for H2O2, the molecular formula mass will be, there are two hydrogens plus there are two oxygens, that is 32, that is equal to 34. What will be the empirical formula mass? There is only one hydrogen in empirical formula, so 1 plus 16 from oxygen, that will be equal to 70. Now we see that the ratio between the molecular formula mass and the empirical formula mass is the same ratio between the molecular formula and the empirical formula. So we say that molecular formula is equal to n times the empirical formula, and this n is equal to the molecular formula mass divided by the empirical formula mass. From here we can see that if we look at these two statements, then n will be equal to 34/17, which is equal to 2. And we see that if we multiply 2 into the empirical formula, we will again get H2O2. Please copy this. Let me know if you're done. If you have any doubt, please ask me. What about Mehreen? Is your internet stable now, or is it still having some issue?
Hello, sir.
Yes, you are audible now. And you are not disconnected, I hope. Yeah, you are here. Okay, yes, Mary, any doubt?
No, sir.
Please write this, raise your hand if you are done. We will do one question in which the empirical formula, we'll start with the empirical formula. You will be given the percentage composition of different elements. Okay, Shweb is done. What about Mehreen, Abdul Wahid? Okay, Mehreen is also done. Abdul Wahid, are you done? Okay. There's one more small concept that you have to know. Just please, you can lower your hands now. It is known as the percentage composition. Okay. So percentage composition is simple, very simple. So if you want to calculate the mass percentage of any element, so mass percentage of an element. Please remember, we have also learned mass percentage, percentage by mass, percentage by weight, percentage W by W in the solution, in the concentration terms. But this mass percentage is different. It is for an element in a particular compound, in a particular compound. So this is equal to, it has similar formula. is the molar mass of that element divided by total molar mass of compound into 100. For example, let us calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen and oxygen. In H2O. Okay, in H2O. So if you look at the percentage of H is equal to, what is the molar mass of hydrogen in that element? The molar in that particular compound, hydrogen's molar mass is 1 grams. But there are 1 grams per mole. But there are two hydrogen atoms, that is why multiplied by 2 divided by the total molar mass of H2O is 18 grams per mole into 100. So this will be equal to the grams per mole, and the grams per mole cancel each other. You will get 1/9 into 100. Please tell me what percentage that will, this would be. 1/9. Should be something 11.11%, right? Now, similarly, percentage of oxygen will be equal to the molar mass of oxygen is, the molar mass of oxygen is how much? 16 grams per mole into 1, because there is only one oxygen atom, divided by 18 grams per mole. This grams per mole will cancel out each other into 100. This will be 16 upon 18 into 100, which is equal to how much? If we subtract that, then this will be 89 point something. Okay, this is 88.89%. Now, the important thing for percentage composition is that there is some questions in NCERT in which you have to calculate the percentage composition of different elements for a given compound. But more important is that you will be given these percentages. Okay, these percentages. Now, what do we understand? If there is in H2O, we say 11% of hydrogen is present in a compound, then you will translate the statement as 11.11 gram of hydrogen is present in 100 grams of compound. Okay, so this statement is more important. Okay, make star marks. This statement is more important, that you can translate 11.11% of hydrogen is present in a compound. It means that 11.11 gram of hydrogen is present in 100 grams of compound. That is most important. The formula is not much important. This concept of translating, it will help you in solving the problems of molecular formula and empirical formula. Please write this down. Raise your hand. Okay, two have already raised hand. Just waiting for Mehreen now. Okay, everyone is done. So let us write a question. A compound contains 69.9% of iron, 69.9% of iron and 30.1% of oxygen. 30.1% of oxygen. Find the empirical formula. Find the empirical formula of compound. So these type of questions are not tough. They are a bit lengthy, and you have to remember the method and also the strategy how to solve these type of questions. You have to remember these steps. Okay, you have to remember these steps. Now all these type of questions, you will make a table. Okay, and in that table, you first of all will write the name of element. You write the element's name first. Element, then you will write the mass percentage. Okay, whatever the percentage masses, okay, the mass. Now, if it is 69.9% iron, you will directly write 69.9 gram. 30.1% of oxygen, that means 30.1 grams. Now, then you will calculate the mole ratio. Okay, we'll calculate the mole ratio. That means you will calculate the number of moles of this much iron and the number of moles of 30.1 gram of oxygen. After that, what you have to do is to calculate the empirical ratio. Empirical ratio. After you have calculated the empirical ratio, you will have to find the whole number ratio. How will you do these things? I will tell you. And after whole number ratio, you have to, you will get the empirical formula. Okay. So elements are what? The elements are, let me make a line like this. Yes. So the elements are Fe. And we have the other element, that is oxygen. Okay, Marine, tell me, what is the mass of Fe? Yes, Marine, what is the mass of Fe? 69.9, right?
Yes.
Not 7. Okay, wait a second. I think this thing hanged. Okay. Yeah, you can see this, but I cannot scroll up and down. I cannot. Okay, let us do this question and then I think we need to rejoin because, okay, no, I cannot write also, no? Can you see anything? Okay, wait a second. It's loading. Please, you guys stay in this in this meeting. I will rejoin in 5 minutes. Okay. I think my computer got freezed. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, yes, everyone is here. So let me just share my screen here. Yeah. Is this visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So masses of iron and oxygen are 69.9. For oxygen, it is 30.1. The mole ratio will be, we put the mass, the given mass 69.9 divided by the molar mass of iron. The molar mass of iron is 56. Now for oxygen, you will write 30.1 divided by the molar mass of oxygen is how much? 16. Now when you calculate these two, approximately what will happen? It will be something around 1.25 or 24. And this will be something around 1.88. Now, what is the empirical ratio that you have to do? Let me just give a separations here. So the first thing that we did is just divide by the molar mass, right? We divide by the molar mass of each of the elements, iron and oxygen. Now in the empirical ratio mass, what we have to do is we have to see whether 1.24 is small or 1.18 is small. The one which is small, we have to divide it by that number. So here we saw that 1.24 is small. So we'll divide 1.24 by 1.24, as well as we will divide 1.88 by how much? 1.24. Now, if you divide 1.24 by 1.24, you will get 1. If you divide 1.88 divided by 1.24, you will get how much? You will get 1.5. Now, as we can see that this ratio is not in whole numbers. This ratio is not in whole numbers. So we'll just convert this into whole numbers. Now, 1 is to 5. 1 is to 1.5. I can write this as 2 is to 3, right? I multiply, say this is 1 upon 1.5. If I multiply 2 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator, it will be same. That is 2 upon 3. So the same thing that we have to do here is to multiply both of these numbers by 2. So you will multiply by 2. You will get 2 here and you will get 3 here. Now, this is your whole number ratio, the simplest whole number ratio, and that is also your empirical formula. The empirical formula will be what? The empirical formula will be, let me just erase this part. And then you will get empirical formula Fe2O3. Okay. So these are the steps. So in the first step, you have to divide by the molar mass. In the second step, you have to divide by the smallest number. Okay. Smallest number. Smallest mole ratio. So you got mole ratio 1.24 and 1.88. In these two, 1.24 was smallest. So you will divide it by that. You will get the empirical ratio. Now, if the empirical ratio is in whole numbers, that is fine. But if it is not in whole number, then you have to convert it into whole numbers by multiplying the same things in the numerator and denominator. Now, 1.5, you have to convert mainly 1.5 to whole numbers. So we have to multiply 2 here in the denominator. And if I have to multiply 2 in the denominator, that means I have to also multiply 2 in the numerator. That's why when I multiply 2 and 2, 2 into 1 is 2, 1.5 into 2 is 3. So please copy this. You have got the empirical formula as Fe2O3. Now we will do one more question, and that question will kind of summarize everything that we have learned in this chapter from stoichiometry to molecular formula and empirical formula, and also percentage composition. Raise your hand if you're done. So these are just the steps that you have to keep in mind. First of all, you write the masses as the percentage is given. Then you write the mole ratio, then the empirical ratio, then the whole number ratio. Raise your hand if you're done. If wave is done, Mareen is done. Waiting for Abdul Wahid. Will Wahid write first? Okay. Others can start writing another question. A building fuel gas contain. Carbon and hydrogen only. Carbon and hydrogen only. Burning a small sample of the gas in oxygen wave. In oxygen, it gave what? It gave 3.38 grams of carbon dioxide and 0.69 grams of H2O. Other information that is given, 10 liters of this sample weighs 11.6 grams, weighs 11.6 grams at STP. Find the empirical formula and molecular formula of the gas. Now all of you will raise hand if you are done writing the question. Now when I start writing the answer, no one will write, okay? You will only see. Raise your hand if you are done writing the question. Okay, everyone is done. So, in this question, we see that there is a gas which contains carbon and hydrogen only. That means it has a compound, and that compound contains only hydrogen and carbon. For example, if you have H2O, then that means H2O contains only hydrogen and oxygen. Okay. Similarly, we have a compound which contains only carbon and hydrogen. That means it is a hydrocarbon. That's okay. That's fine. That's one thing that you have to understand. When we say it contains only carbon and hydrogen, does not mean that it contains simple carbon and simple hydrogen. It contains carbon and hydrogen in a molecule. Okay. And that molecule has only carbon and hydrogens, no other elements. The next sentence is that burning of small sample of gas and oxygen gives 3.38 grams of CO2 and 0.69 grams of H2O. That means we are doing a reaction. Now, as soon as we are doing a reaction, that means we have to do some kind of stoichiometric calculation. And for stoichiometric calculation, the first thing that we calculate is the number of moles. So we will calculate the number of moles of CO2 and we will calculate the number of moles of H2O. So the first thing that we are going to do is to calculate number of moles. Now, please don't write anything. Please see here. Number of moles of CO2 is equal to the given mass divided by the molar mass. What is the given mass here, Mehreen, of CO2? You can see, don't write in chat. What is the given mass of CO2 in this question, anyone? You can't see. Yes. Why you guys so take so much of time? 3.38 grams. What is the molar mass? Do you remember, Mehreen? Molar mass of CO2? Okay, 44 grams. Okay, we have done it many times. That is why I thought that you may remember. 44 grams per mole. Okay, so initially, if you remember the molar mass, now when I taught gram atomic mass and gram molecular mass, in gram molecular mass, I gave you plenty of elements from which you can calculate the gram molecular mass. Now, those gram molecular mass of those compounds are important for this chapter. And if you remember it, that will help you. And we will write this as 3.38 divided by 44. moles. We will not solve it, okay? Because we have to do further calculation. That is why we will not solve it. Now we'll write number of moles of H2O. It's again, it is equal to the given mass of H2O divided by the molar mass of H2O. Given mass of H2O is 0.69 grams. The molar mass of H2O is 18 grams per mole. Now grams and grams will cancel out each other. We will again keep this as fractions. We will not simplify to decimals because we have to do further calculations. Now, we have calculated the number of moles. Now we will look at the reactions. What is going to happen? Now, burning a small sample of the gas and oxygen gives itna grams of CO2 and this much grams of H2O. Now, when we are doing a reaction in which there is carbon and hydrogens only, now CO2 will be formed by the reaction of carbons only, right? So we can write the first statement, first reaction, that is carbon plus oxygen. This will give me CO2. Whatever CO2 is being formed is formed only due to the carbon which is present in this particular molecule and this carbon. So carbon dioxide is not formed by hydrogen. So I'm not writing anything for hydrogen. We'll first calculate the mass of carbon present in the sample burned, mass of carbons that is burnt in the sample. Now carbon plus oxygen gives CO2. Now I will write the neat statement, the form statement, right? Because we have to give the CO2, right? 3.38 grams of CO2. So according to the equation, we have 1 mole of CO2, and 1 mole of CO2 requires how many moles of carbon? So we have to find out number of moles of carbon required. So we are calculating some amount of reactant that is required. That is why I will write the neat statement. So the first neat statement will be 1 mole of CO2 needs 1 mole of carbon. That's okay. Does everyone understand this line? Why I have written this line and how I have written this line? Yes or no? 1 mole of CO2 needs 1 mole of carbon. Okay. Now, how many moles of CO2 do we have? We have 3.38 divided by 44 moles of carbon dioxide, and we need to find out how many moles of carbon is required to make this many amount of carbon dioxide. So 3.38 divided by 44 mole of CO2 needs, if 1 mole of CO2 needs 1 mole of carbon, 2 mole will need 2 mole, 3 mole will need 3 mole, 3.38 by 44 mole will need the same amount, that is 3.38 divided by 44 mole of carbon. Now we have required mass of carbon is now with us. So next statement is mass of carbon. Mass of carbon required. We have got the moles. Okay. So this will be number of moles into the molar mass. What is the number of moles here? 3.38 divided by 44 mole into carbon's mass is 12 grams per mole. So this mole and mole inverse will cancel out each other, and we will get 3.38 divided by 44. Now, if we calculate 3.38 divided by 44, it will be 3.38 divided by 44 into 12. So this is equal to 0.9218 grams. We have got the mass of carbon required to get this many amount of carbon dioxide. The same thing we will do with hydrogen. So the mass of, okay, for hydrogen, the reaction will be H2 plus O2. It is giving me what? H2O. And is the reaction balanced? Tell me, is the reaction balanced?
No,
we have 2 oxygens now. So we'll write 2 here, and there are 4 hydrogens now. So we'll write 2 hydrogens here. Now, according to the equation, 2 moles of H2O needs 2 moles of needs 2 mole of H2. Okay, 2 mole of H2O needs 2 mole of H2. Now, what mass of hydrogen do we have? Number of moles of H2 is 0.69, right? So 2 moles will need 2 moles. 1 mole will need How many moles of H2O? Oh, sorry, one mole of H2O needs how many moles of H2? Mehreen?
One.
Two moles need. Yeah, very good. One mole of H2. And the moles of H2O that we have is 0.69 by 18 mole of H2O needs. How many moles? 0.69 by 18 mole of H2. Now we have got the number of moles of H2. We will find out the mass of H2. Mass of H2 will be equal to number of moles into molar mass of H2. Number of moles is equal to how much? 0.69 by 18 mole into. For H2, the molar mass will be 2 grams. Please remember, this is H2, not hydrogen. This is H2. This will be 2 grams per mole. So mole inverse and mole will cancel out each other. You will get 0.69 by 9. 0.69 by 9. And this will be around 0.0766. If I can remember correctly, let me do this. 0.69 divided by 9 is equal to, yes, 0.076666. Okay. So this 666 will, we can write it 667. This is how much we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have already 1, 2, 3, 4. So let me write it 6, 7. Okay, 0.767. Now we have got the mass of carbon and mass of hydrogen, both of them. Mass of carbon that was burned was equal to 0.9218. The mass of hydrogen, which was in the sample which was burned, it is equal to 0.0767. Now both of these are in grams. So what will be the mass of sample? So mass of sample will be the addition, because the sample contains only carbon and hydrogen. So 8 plus 7 is 5, carry 1. 6 plus 2 is 8, 7 plus 2 is 9, and 9 is 9. So 0.9985 grams is the mass of sample. Now the next thing that you have to calculate is the mass percentage of carbon. This will be equal to the amount of carbon which is present is 0.9218. The amount of sample which is present is 0.9985. Right? The marks you obtained by total mass, so mass of carbon by total mass, it is into 100. So this will be around something 92.32%. Now comes mass of, sorry, mass percentage of hydrogen. Mass percentage of hydrogen, what you will do, 0.0767 grams divided by 0.9985. And you multiply this by 1,100, you will get something around 0.7. This will be 0.7.68. Okay, let me just try it. Do this once. 0.0766667 divided by 0.9985. Yeah, 0.768. That will be 92.32. Yeah. So as of now, you have got mass of carbon and percentage of mass percentage of hydrogen. Please start writing from here. Let me know if I have to do scroll up or scroll down. The first thing that you did is calculate the number of moles, okay? Whatever mass was given, you have to calculate the number of moles first of all. Then only you will proceed. Raise your hand and then I will scroll down. It was done. Waiting for Mehreen and Abdul Wahid. Okay, Mehreen is also done. Just waiting for Abdul Wahid. Abdul Wahid, please raise your hand if you're done. Again, I'm lowering your hand. Raise your hand if you're done with this part also. Shweb is done, waiting for Mehreen and Abdul Wahid. Okay, everyone is done. I'm again lowering your hands. You can again raise your hand and then we can move, scroll down. Mehreen is done. Yes, Abdul Wahid and Shoaib, raise your hand if you are done writing. So I can scroll down, that's bit left. Okay. So one thing that I want to get your attention towards is the percentage mass of carbon is given. And you have also calculated the percentage mass of hydrogen. I want all of you to get the empirical formula. We have done empirical formula right now. From the mass percentage of iron and oxygen, please apply the same steps. You have got the mass of carbon, you have got the mass of hydrogen, and calculate the empirical formula of the sample of gas. Can you do that, Mehreen, Abdul Wahid, Shoaib?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Please start, okay? So the elements that you have now. Carbon and hydrogen. The mass percentage mass that you have is 92.32. For hydrogen, it is 7.68. Mass, you will write the mole ratio. After mole ratio, empirical ratio. If this empirical ratio, for mole ratio, you have to divide by the molar mass. For empirical ratio, you have to divide by smallest mole ratio, whatever you get here. Okay, so 92.32 divided by 12, 7.68 divided by 1. This will be 7.68 only. And we have 92.32 divided by 12. This will be around 7.69. So as you can see, both of them are approximately same. So you can write 7.69 divided by 7.68. 7.68 divided by 7.68. Both of this will come approximately equal to 1, and this will be also equal to 1. So we have already got the empirical ratio as 1:1. So empirical formula will be carbon and hydrogen only, one carbon and one hydrogen. Please write this, raise your hand if you're done. After that, we will calculate the molar mass, okay?
So do we not have to write the whole number?
No, because we already have the whole number, no? Because empirical formula, we want the whole number, but when we already have the whole number, then we don't want, right?
Yes, sir.
So empirical ratio, directly we got whole numbers. Raise your hand if you're done. Waiting for Abdul Wahid. So there is an information given in the question regarding the, okay, we have got the empirical formula now. So let us also find the empirical formula mass first. Empirical formula mass will be equal to, for carbon it is 12 plus hydrogen it is 1, so it will be 13 grams, okay? So it will be 13 grams, the empirical formula mass. Now, let us move on to the information that is given. Said that 10 liter of gas weighs 10 liter of gas weighs 11.6 grams at STP. So what will be the mass of 1 liter of gas, Mary?
1.6.
Yeah, it will be 11.6 divided by 10 grams at STP. Now, if you know the 1 liter, then I can find for 22.4 liters, right? Of gas will weigh 22.4 into 11.6 divided by 10 grams at STP. Please calculate this now. What is this value? No, you may have done some mistake. 22.4 into 11.6 divided by 10. Do it once more, Mahreen. What others got the answer? Shoaib, Abdul Wahid, calculate this and tell me what is the answer. It will be less than 30. So you have, see, 11.6 and 10, it is almost same. So maybe you will get something around maybe 25 or something.
Yes, sir, 25.9.
So we can approximately say that it is equal to 25.9. And what is the next number? Did you calculate that also?
Yes, sir.
Nine. It is 9.8, right? So we can approximately say that it is equal to 26 grams, correct? Approximately equal to 26 grams. Now, what is this? What is special about 22.4 liters? What is special about 22.4 liter of a gas? What is special about this? It is the molar volume, na? The volume occupied by 1 mole of gas. So when I wrote 22.4 liter of gas will be this much, then means I am writing 1 mole of gas will weigh this many grams. Now, 1 mole of gas means this is the molar mass. Molar mass of gas is equal to 26 grams. Did you understand the relationship between 22.4 and 1 mole of gas and then 2 molar mass? See, 22.4 liter of gas at STP is 1 mole of gas. The mass of 1 mole of gas is the molar mass of the gas. So we have got the molar mass also, we have got the empirical formula mass also. Now we can calculate the N. Or N, we should not write N or X, whatever you want to write. X is equal to the molecular formula mass divided by empirical formula mass. The molecular formula mass is 26 grams divided by empirical formula mass will be 13 grams. Grams and grams will cancel out each other. You will get 2. Now we can also write molecular formula is equal to 2 into the empirical formula. So molecular formula will be 2 into the empirical formula is CH. So this will be C2H2. So please write this down from 10 liters. Let me know when you are done. This question includes stoichiometry. It also includes percentage composition. It also includes the molecular formula. It also includes the empirical formula. It is multi-conceptual question. Okay. Mahreen, how many pages did this question require? from question to complete answer?
Three.
How much? Three.
Yes, sir.
3 pages, right? Now, if you are able to do this question without looking at the answer, so you read it 10 times, so you read it 20 times. No matter how many times you want to read it, you can read it. But I won't suggest that you read it 20 times. What I would suggest is read it one time and try to do it on your own. If you cannot do, then close it. Then read it once again, once only, not twice or thrice. Once, understand the concept, understand the relation between the steps, why you are doing which steps in this manner. Then again, close it. Then once again, do it. Okay. Now, the only thing that will help you in chemistry is not my teaching, is your practice. Because I am the same person teaching to everyone. But what matters is the practice of students. Someone who practices a lot. Okay, now practices a lot. For me, a lot is what? If you redo the questions that we are doing in the chemistry class, that is enough. And at the end of the chapter, you should also do the complete NCERT exercises. Now, this question is already in NCERT exercises. The question that we did on CaCO3 reacting with 0.25 ml of 0.75 molar of HCl, that is also in NCERT. Okay, so these two questions, which are tough ones, I have already done. Most of the questions now in NCERT, you can already do it. Now, there are some portions which is known as significant figures. Okay. Significant figures you have already done in physics class, right? Significant figures you have done in physics class? No? Mehreen? Have you done? Yes, no? So that is the same significant figures in the chemistry also. You don't have to read significant figures again in chemistry. Whatever the teacher has taught you in physics, the same significant figures is also in chemistry. Same goes for accuracy, precision, these type of terms. And also the measurement, the physical quantities, what are the 7 physical quantities, what are its SI units, those things are same in chemistry also. Okay. So your chapter 1 is completely done. In the next class, I will take a few doubts, and if you don't have some doubts, then I will start with chapter 2. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So this is the molecule C2H2. C2H2, that means there is 2 carbons. So 2 carbons and 1 hydrogen for each carbon. That means carbon will have a triple bond. So if this is a 2-carbon hydrocarbon, that means it is eth. There's a triple bond. That is why YNE, ethyne. So ethyne is the gas which is used for welding. Okay. So whenever someone is welding, now you will see there are 2 things that they carry in hand. So one of them is gas and the other is fire equipment. Okay. Are you guys done?
Yes.
Yes. No. Yes. Okay. What about Abdul Wahid, Shoaib? Are you?